3 trials were published about endovascular therapy for ischemic stroke. This was the one trial. All trials were similar, so I will combine all three together. One was endovascular therapy for ischemic stroke with perfusion imaging selection. Another was thrombectomy within 8 hours after symptom onset for ischemic stroke. And third was stent retrieval thrombectomy after intravenous TPA versus TPA alone in stroke. So all were published in NEJM. What was this 3 trial? Here 70 patients were studied, here nearly 200 patients were studied. All 3 trials were almost similar. Mean age was around 66 here, 70 here. Time since onset to the completion of the interventional thrombectomy was up to 6 or 8 hours. Beginning of intervention was around 3 to 3.5 hours. NI, National Institute of Health stroke score, the lower the better, was around 15 to 17 at the time of admission. Follow-up was for 3 months. Endpoint was Rankin score in all 3 trials. What was the primary endpoint result? Everywhere, this Rankin score was better with endovascular thrombectomy. So message from this trial was that in patients with ischemic stroke with a proximal cerebral arterial occlusion and salvageable tissue on CT perfusion imaging, early thrombectomy as compared to only LTAPLASE improved reperfusion, early neurological recovery and functional outcome. So it should be done. So take home message from all this trial was, in Pegasus TME 54 trial, addition of ticagrelor to aspirin in old MI patient reduced MACE at the cost of increased major bleeding, but there was no increased fetal bleeding and there was no increase in ICH. And on same topic, meta-analysis of all these trials, prolonged DAPT after old MI reduces major adverse cardiac as well as cerebrovascular events at the cost of increased major bleeding. Again, no fetal bleeding, no increased ICH. And this was regardless of DAPT regimen, duration or type of MI or PCA status. So we should give DAPT in a low bleeding risk patients. Cyclosporine in NTR MI did not reduce MACE, did not improve LV remodeling at 1 year. In PROMISE trial, we saw that in patients with suspected CAD, initial anatomic screening by CT angiography was equivalent to functional assessment by stress ECG, echo or nuclear scan, although CTA had less false positive results. EMPAR age outcome in high cardiovascular risk diabetic patients, SGLT2 inhibitor empagliflozin was significantly beneficial in reducing composite adverse outcome, including death and hospitalization for heart failure. It was first anti-diabetic drug to show CV outcome benefit of this magnitude. In TECOS trial, among patients with type 2 diabetes and established cardiovascular disease, sitagliflozin did not increase MACE and heart failure hospitalization, and thus it proved cardiovascular safety. And lastly, in EXTEND IA, REVAST and SWIFT PRIME trials, among patients with acute ischemic stroke, endovascular thrombectomy was beneficial for better neurological recovery.